4 people are killed in a shootout in Kosovo following a resurgence of violence in the restive north. Ethnic Serb gunmen in armored vehicles stormed the village of Banska, battling police and barricading themselves in a Serb Orthodox monastery. One police officer and 3 of the attackers died. Ethnic Albanians form the vast majority of the 1.8 million population of Kosovo, a former province of Serbia. But some 50,000 Serbs in the north have never accepted Kosovo's 2008 Declaration of Independence. France set to end its military cooperation with Niger. French President Emmanuel Macron says he's pulling 1,500 troops out of the African country by the end of the year. France stationed troops in Niger to assist with counterterrorism missions, but Macron says his country will not be held hostage by Niger's military leaders who refuse to fight terrorism. France has not recognized Niger's military authorities, insisting ousted President Mohamed Bazoum remains the country's legitimate leader. Bazoum was toppled in a coup back in July. Ethnic Armenians in Nagorno-Karabakh begin a massive exodus toward Armenia after Azerbaijan defeated the breakaway region's fighters. The Karabakh leadership says the 120,000 Armenians in the region do not want to live as part of Azerbaijan for fear of persecution and ethnic cleansing. The Armenians of Karabakh were forced to surrender last week after a 24-hour military operation by the much larger Azerbaijan military. Armenia and Azerbaijan have fought 2 wars over the enclave in 30 years, with Azerbaijan gaining back swaths of territory in and around Nagorno-Karabakh in 2020. The U.S. government is less than a week away from a possible shutdown if House Republicans fail to reach a compromise on spending bills that divide the party. More in this report.
In less than 1 week, the U.S. government will shut down if Congress can't come to agreements on spending bills that have so far exposed divisions within the Republican Party. A group of ultra-right-wing conservatives has threatened mutiny against and the ouster of House Speaker Kevin McCarthy following a spending compromise between him and President Joe Biden earlier this year to avoid defaulting on the nation's debt.
This is because Republicans can't even agree among themselves. And remember, Kevin McCarthy and Speaker McCarthy and President Biden made a deal. And that deal was tough for all sides. Frankly, it was tough for our department. It meant cutting back on some things we wanted to do, some funds we were going to use to improve roads and bridges and airports. But we accepted that because that was the deal that was made earlier this year. And now all we're doing is asking them to live up to that deal.
That same group of Republicans who are members of the controlling party in the House of Representatives wants deep cuts to domestic spending as well as to U.S. support for Ukraine in its ongoing war against invading Russia. President Biden last week welcomed Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky to the White House after the two spoke at the United Nations General Assembly in New York. Biden pledged continued and unwavering support to Ukraine.
The people of Ukraine are steeled for this struggle ahead. And the United States is going to continue to stand with you.
McCarthy left $300 million of funding for Ukraine in an embattled defense spending bill before the House of Representatives. It's something unlikely to endear his far-right flank.
I'll bet on Kevin McCarthy any day, and we certainly have time yet to go. But he's in a very difficult position because the holdouts keep saying to Kevin McCarthy, don't bring bipartisan bills to the floor. We don't want you to use Democrat votes to try to avert a shutdown. But they're using Democrat votes to try to cause a shutdown. And these individuals, these Republican holdouts, are voting with Nancy Pelosi against Republican bills that have been brought to the floor.
McCarthy's party holds a slim majority in the House. Even as few as 5 Republican defectors are enough to derail any legislation the majority attempts to pass. Lawmakers who spent the weekend away from Washington returned Tuesday to try again to avert a government shutdown, which will happen at 12:01 a.m. October 1st if lawmakers fail to agree on even a short-term funding bill. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.
The U.S. has agreed to jointly produce weapons with Ukraine. That revelation from Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky on Sunday, who described the move as an absolute fantasy. Zelensky said the deal includes air defense systems that are crucial for Ukraine to defend itself from Russia's air attacks. The Ukrainian leader recently returned from a visit to the U.S. and Canada, where he met with President Joe Biden and Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. A long-awaited asteroid sample has landed on Earth, a NASA space capsule carrying the largest soil sample ever scooped up from the surface of an asteroid, parachuted into the Utah desert, delivering the specimen to scientists. This is a first for NASA. It was only the third asteroid sample and by far the biggest ever returned to Earth for analysis. The previous two asteroid samples were taken by Japan's Space Agency in 2010 and 2020. The mission caps a six-year joint mission between NASA and the University of Arizona. Asian Games host China off to a dominant start in the regional competition. China already has 43 medals, including 27 golds, to top the latest medal tally. One of China's latest gold medals came via swimming, with prodigy Pan Zhanlei becoming the first Asian swimmer to break the 47-second mark in the 100 meters freestyle. In second place in the medal standings is South Korea, with 5 golds and a total of 16 medals. Japan is in third place, followed by Uzbekistan and Hong Kong. The Philippines is tied in 16th place with a bronze medal courtesy of Patrick King Perez in the men's individual Pumse event. Hitmaker Usher will be headlining the highly anticipated Super Bowl halftime show next year. This was announced by the National Football League and the R&B singer himself. The sports spectacle is scheduled for February 11, 2024. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cban.com. Well, some 3.4 million beer lovers have so far trooped to the world's largest beer festival in Munich, Germany. This as the 2.5-week-long Oktoberfest celebrates halftime with singing, cheering, and of course, beer drinking. Organizers say most of the visitors came from the U.S., Austria, Italy, and France. Oktoberfest, which traces its origins from a horse race that took place more than 2 centuries ago, attracts about 6 million visitors every year. Museums are usually reserved for works of art, but this one in Washington, D.C. showcases more than 150 products from around the world that failed. Take a look.
A chair inspired by the hula hoop was supposed to help you exercise while at the office, but simply made people dizzy. A bicycle made of plastic wobbled and flopped when in use.
Wow, she really chews!
And a doll designed to chew plastic food was also capable of nibbling children's fingers. These are just a few examples of the more than 150 failed products that are currently on display at the Museum of Failure in Washington. Samuel West is its founder.
It's products and services that people who invested money and resources into them had very high expectations that good things would happen, and things did not turn out the way they'd planned.
The objects represent a range of industries, from disasters at sea to impractical, pricey, and dangerous modes of transport on land. West says some are downright senseless.
A face mask that gives your face electric shocks to make you look more beautiful. A golf club that you urinate into so that you don't have to go to the bathroom out when you play golf.
West, who's a psychologist by trade, says failure is important for progress. So part of the museum's goal is to destigmatize failure.
In the United States, it's a society obsessed with success. So failure is very sensitive, especially in the corporate world. So this is a big problem for organizations, because if you don't accept the fact that you fail, you will not be innovative and you will not be able to learn from your failures.
West points to companies with products that initially failed, but later evolved to become great sensations. Video game giant Nintendo is one example.
They have failed spectacularly with different inventions. One is called the Power Glove. It's a glove you put on to control the computer game. Complete failure. Another one was a 3D gaming console that you had to sit like this to look into,
which apparently could damage the eyesight of children if used for more than 10 or 15 minutes.
But Nintendo learned from these failures and created one of the most successful video gaming consoles of all time, the Nintendo Wii.
Before leaving, visitors have a chance to share their own failures.
Most of the things that people write on the Share Your Failure wall are things that they didn't do, as opposed to things that they did.
A sign, perhaps, that the subtle message of nothing ventured, nothing gained, even at the risk of failure, is getting through. Julie Tabo, VOA News, Washington.